Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Skytop Stadium on South Campus here at Syracuse University. The first of a four-game series featuring the Clemson Tigers and the Syracuse Orange. I'm Brendan Hodges, and welcome into our audience on an overcast Friday afternoon. Some great softball on tap. As one of the newest programs in the nation, the Clemson Tigers look to try and continue their role through the ACC. Syracuse, meanwhile, looking to improve their seeding heading into the ACC tournament. Lineups being introduced right now. That is concluded. We have the national anthem coming up. We'll step aside, have the starting lineups for you right after this. The head coach of the Syracuse Orange. Again, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Skytop Stadium on the campus of Syracuse University. Once again, I'm Brendan Hodges for game one. This four-game series between the Clemson Tigers and the Syracuse Orange. We stand in solidarity. Clemson coming into this game, as I said before, on an absolute roll. Winners. We pledge to do more than speak up. Winners of 17 straight games. They had a series at Notre Dame postponed in the middle of that, so it could be larger. Right now, sitting alone atop the ACC softball standings and trying to have one more superb weekend to go into the ACC tournament as the top seed. Syracuse, meanwhile, is coming off of a four-game series loss, sweet in sweet fashion, behind the plate, here at Skytop against Virginia Tech. At third. Scored two runs in that series. Fans, Virginia Tech's 30. They had struggled against the Hokie pitching. And it won't get easier please today. We'll talk about that a little bit later when the Tigers take the field. For now, though, let's take a look around the outfield, infield, and see how Syracuse lines up. Harris Woods, Tony Martin, Angel Hasso going from left to right field. Around the horn, it's Rebecca Clyde at third, Nelly Casares-Mayer at short, Gabby Tehran at second, and Callista Almer at first. Behind the plate, Gianna Torres, and in the circle to start today for the Syracuse Orange is Alexa Romero, the grad student. Started 18 games this year, 7-8 on the season, 3.07 ERA. The Orange will need her to be big today and this weekend if they want to try and steal a win from this Clemson team. Up and down the lineup for the Tigers, meanwhile. Leadoff, Mackenzie Clark, freshman outfielder Ainsley Gilstrap hits second. Valerie Cagle, we'll be talking about her all weekend, that's for sure, hitting third. Marissa Gambarda in the cleanup spot. Kaya Keller, Morgan Johnson, Grace Matamore, Casey Pigham, and Cammie Pereira round out the lineup for the Tigers. But it is Mackenzie Clark who will step in first to face off against Alexa Romero. First pitch at 3 o'clock on the dot. Fastball fouled back into the screen. We are underway. 56 degrees here in Syracuse. This game pushed up an hour earlier today because of impending rain that couldn't make its way through here. 0-1 rises out of the zone. Mackenzie Clark. 363 hitting on the season. That pitch low out of the zone, ball two. And Clark, just one of the fantastic young players on this Clemson team. Clemson itself, a very young program as well, just their second year in competition. Ball three low. Taken for strike two. Romero nicks the corner. Count full. Pitch from Romero. Swung on, lifted into left field, going back on it is Paris Woods. She's at the wall, and she'll make the catch on the warning track. A long fly ball.
Now batting, playing shortstop, number 8, Ainsley Gilstra.
From Mackenzie Clark, and she just missed that one. Woods steps from the wall, made the catch. First hitter retired. Ainsley Gilstrap will now step in for Clemson. She takes ball one high. Gilstrap, one of several graduate students on this Clemson side. One of the graduate students that transferred to Clemson as well to play at a program that was just getting started. Spent her first 3 years at South Carolina Upstate. Saw a lot of action there, redshirted in 2019 before the inaugural season for these Tigers in 2020. Liner into left field, Woods over, makes the diving catch! Paris Woods has had an eventful first half inning.
Now batting, the pitcher number 72.
First, a long high fly ball that was twisting in the wind finds her mitt, and then an absolute rope from the bat of Ainsley Gilstrap. Diving catch, snow coned it. Did well to keep it from falling out. So two down here, Valerie Cagle. How good has she been this year? A red shirt freshman who in her true freshman season hit .387. That was the inaugural season for Clemson again. This year hitting .411, 12 home runs and 35 RBIs, and that's not all she can do. Fastball taken inside for ball three.
Yeah, full out of the screen.
The 3-0 from Romero. Take in for strike one on the outside corner. Romero trying to work her way back in the count. Swinging and fouling it off as Cagle down the third base line. Count goes full. The second time in this inning. And ball four. Cagle aboard on a walk.
Now batting, playing right field number 25, Marissa.
And then we'll step cleanup hitter, right fielder, Marissa Gambarda. Hitting .327 on the season. First pitch taken for strike one. Barda has 11 home runs, 38 RBIs in her own right, so close equals with Cagle in regards to hitting. High, ball two. Excuse me, ball one. Count goes even at one in piece. One low and away, ball two. Two, one, low again, runner goes, Cagle to second, throw down in time. Gianna Torres, a frozen rope to second, and that'll do it. for the top of the first. No runs, no hits. And we head to the bottom of the first. We'll have the Syracuse lineup and the defensive alignment for Clemson when we come back. Clemson nothing, Syracuse coming to. Back here on the ACC Network Extra. Top of the first, Clemson goes scoreless with two fantastic defensive plays, one routine. Harris Woods had a busy first half inning. High fly ball on a full count from the leadoff hitter Mackenzie Clark. Backed her up to the track, made the catch. Next hitter Ainsley Gilstrap lines one right to her, has to dive and make the catch. She does. And then Gianna Torres, with Kago looking to steal second, throws her out with plenty of room to spare. And now we'll see Cagle in the circle. But first, the defensive alignment for the Clemson Tigers. Grace Matamor, Mackenzie Clark, Marissa Gambarda will man the outfield left to right. Around the horn, Casey Bigham will step into third. Ainsley Gilstrap playing it short. Cammie Pereira will take her space at second. Kaya Keller sits at first base. Behind the plate this afternoon for the Tigers is JoJo Hyatt. And as I mentioned before, Valerie Cagle. Redshirt freshman, 23-3 in 41 appearances this season. .94 ERA, that is absolutely ridiculous, and she does it with velocity. Hitters only averaging 180 against her, and we'll see if Syracuse has any luck this afternoon. Calista Ulmer will step in to lead things off for the Orange. First pitch, taken, strike one. Was on a call with Syracuse head coach Shannon Depking, and all she could talk about with Valerie Cagle was the velocity. Said that any hitter in the ACC would have trouble keeping up with it. 1-1 the count to Ulmer. Take strike two. Swing and a miss, strike three. That will sit down Ulmer. Rest of the Syracuse lineup goes like this. Angel Paso, freshman outfielder, stepping into the box. Now Nelly Casares-Mayer, one of the few seniors who are very important to the Syracuse team, hitting third. Gabby Tehran hitting cleanup by Lonnie Mayfield, fifth. Gianna Torres, Tony Martin, Rebecca Clyde, Paris Woods. Round out the rest of the lineup. First pitch to Paso, fouled off for strike one. Also hitting .255 on the season. 18 RBIs, 4 home runs to her good name. Pitch taken outside for ball one. Also watches strike two. Nip the outside corner. One, two. Blew it right by her. Cagle's second strikeout in as many batters. And just like that, two down.
Number 11, Nelly Caceres.
And then we'll set the three hitter. Nelly Casares-Mayer. .356 hitter on the season. She takes ball one inside. Yeah. Liner towards the gap, going back on it, and watching it go over the fence is Mackenzie Clark. Nelly Caceres-Mayer. Second pitch she sees gets the party started for Syracuse. And they lead 1-0. What a shot.
Now batting, playing second base, number 4, Gabby Terran.
Syracuse, who had only 2 runs in the entire series against Virginia Tech, get one on the board against Valerie Cagle in their first trip up to the plate. Gabby Terran will look to make some noise as well. She's aggressive at the start, swinging at strike one. Caceres-Mayer, though, 6th homer on the season. Grounder here towards shortstop. Gilstrap up with it, over to first to end the inning. But Syracuse strikes first. Nelly Caceres-Mayer hits one deep off of Valerie Cagle, and we head to the top of the second. It's 1-0, Cuse.
Our score, Syracuse 1, Clemson.
Top of the second here on ACC Network Extra. Brendan Hodges watching alongside you. 1-0 Syracuse on top of the Clemson Tigers, and that's thanks to Nelly Caceres-Mayer. Opposite field home run. Puts the Cuse up 1-0, and Clemson will look to answer here. Again, Clemson looking to leave this weekend as the outright ACC regular season champions in just their second season as a program. So far they haven't pushed anything across. It's their second crack at the bats here. Marissa Gambarda steps in. She was up last inning, but Valerie Cagle was thrown out stealing second. And she takes ball one in the dirt. Gambarda, 327 hitter on the year, 11 homers, 38 RBIs. Fastball fouled off. Count even at 1-1. Fastball up for ball two. Two-one from Romero. In the dirt, tried to get Gambarda swinging. Could not count to 3-1. Outside, and Gambarda will take first on the free pass. Second walk issued out by Alexa Romero.
Now batting, playing first base, number 58, Kaya Keller.
First did not hurt her, but now we're heading into the heart of the Tiger order. Kaya Keller. Another one of these redshirt freshmen that spent their first year at Clemson waiting to start this program's history. 304 hitter on the season. First pitch to her, taken for strike one. The 0-1. Swung on, grounded towards second. Over to second for one in time. Caceres-Mayer will hold it there on the fielder's choice. So Gambarda cut down at second. Keller moves to first on the fielder's choice.
Now batting the designated player, number 42, Morgan Johnson.
One out. Same situation now for Morgan Johnson. Redshirt freshman, 344 hitter on the season. Four homers, 14 RBIs. Swing and a miss. Johnson slated as the designated player here for Clemson in game one of this series. Down early in the count, 0-1. Alexa Romero, second pitch on the way. In there, strike two. The 0-2 from Romero. Swing and a miss. Romero's first strikeout of the day.
Now batting, playing left field, number 27, Grace Matamor.
Two down here in the top of the second. One runner on is Kaya Keller. Grace Matamor, hidden in the seven hole, steps into the box, the Army transfer. First pitch to her, thought about swinging, took it instead, and it's a good choice. She takes ball one. 263 hitter on the season, has walked 12 times, twice as many times as she struck out. Ooh, ball one, ball two high. Again, Matamor was winding up to take a whack at it, decided against it. Crouching in her stance. The 2-0. Outside, ball three. Rio from Romero. Taken upstairs, ball four. Matamor reaches on the free pass. Keller will move to second. And Gianna Torres will have a quick discussion with Alexa Romero.
Now batting, playing third base, number two, Casey
with Casey Bigham. Stepping into the batter's box. She hits from the right side. 231 hitter on the year. First chance with a runner in scoring position for Clemson. And the first pitch outside. Two down here in the top of the second. Syracuse leads 1-0. Romero misses again, low outside. And now another meeting in the circle. As we have this quick break here, just take a look at what Clemson has done in their short time as a program. And I say short because it has been almost nothing there. First competitive season, 2020, picked to finish 10th in the ACC. They went 19-8. They had only lost one ACC game before the COVID shutdown. And now they are 37-4, they have been on fire. This year especially. Strike for Romero. Conversation calmed her down a tad, and now the count goes to 2-1. The 2-1, same spot in there, strike two. Trying to close out this inning. send their team into the bottom of the second, up one. The 2-2. Swing and a miss. Romero gets out of the first trouble she's seen today and sends us to the bottom of the second.
The Clemson Tigers.
Two runners left for Clemson. 1-0. Head to the bottom of the second on ACC Network Extra.
Two runners left on base.
Bottom of the second here on ACC Network Extra. Brendan Hodges coming to you from Skytop Stadium on the campus of Syracuse University. The Orange leading the Clemson Tigers 1-0 as we head to the bottom of the second. That lone run coming courtesy of Nelly Casares Mayer. Opposite field shot against a pitcher who had been dominant really all year. Cagle has not made many mistakes when it comes to being in the circle. It was only the fourth home run she'd given up all year long. Only the 32nd run that she'd given up as well. And now she will face off against the end of the heart of the order, as well as the bottom of the first time. Leilani Mayfield, designated player here in this first game of the four-game series, steps into the left-handed batter's box for her first crack against Valerie Cagle. Cagle goes right after her, grounder at the middle. Will get through the infield for a base hit. No hesitation from Mayfield. Takes a swing at the first pitch, sends it into the center field on the ground. And an early runner on for Syracuse again. Gianna Torres catching today, 164 hitter on the season. Squirm for bunt, ball gets by into the backstop. Mayfield takes second on the pass ball. JoJo Hyatt couldn't handle the pitch low and away. That's 1-0 to Torres with a runner in scoring position. The 1-0 from Cagle. Pumps one right into the zone, strike one. Cagle squaring to bunt, Torres whiffs on it. Strike two is the call as Hyatt appealed down to third. 1-2 to Torres. Cagle slowing things down a bit. Up and out of the zone for ball two. The 2-2. Inside, dropped by Hyatt again. Mayfield will advance, this time to third. Two passed balls in the at-bat. Move Mayfield from first to third, and now Torres with a full count has a chance to drive in a second run for Syracuse. She will not, though. Pain in the corner is Cagle. Sitting Torres down looking.
Now batting playing center field, number 26, Tony Martin.
Tony Martin will now step in for Syracuse. First pitch watched for ball one. Mayfield stands at third. Martin hitting 194 this season, and this time she'll take strike ball. One swung on. Pitch dropping out of the bottom of the zone. Martin unable to connect. Count goes to 1-2. Rise ball up and out of the zone. Martin able to stay off it. Count goes even to 2-2. Another rise ball out of the zone. Count goes full. Payoff pitch from Cagle. Check swing, strike three anyway. Two straight dropped. Looking for Valerie Cagle.
Now batting playing third base, number three, Rebecca Klein.
Both on full count pitches. So now two down after Leilani Mayfield singled up the middle on the first pitch of her at bat. Grounder over to second. Easy work for Cami Pereira to end the inning. Syracuse threatening again. Couldn't get anything done that time, though. Score remains 1-0 as we head to the top of the third. Up next for Clemson, Cami Pereira. And on the top of the order, we'll have it for you here on ACC Network Extra right after this. Top of the third here at Skytop Stadium. Syracuse has a 1-0 lead. Off of that home run back in the first inning by Nelly Casares-Mayer. They have played stellar defense as well when they've had to. Harris Woods, the headliner out in left field from that first inning. First play routine, but the ball hit to the warning track. She made the catch, and then next batter, next pitch even, Ainsley Gilstrap lined on right to her, diving play made by Woods. A runner caught stealing already in this game for the Syracuse catcher, Gianna Torres. And now Alexa Romero, who got out of trouble in the last inning, will face off against the nine-hole hitter, Cami Pereira. First pitch, just a bit outside, ball one. Pereira is one of a few Clemson Tigers that started her career at Furman and then transferred into Clemson to play with an infant program and just brought the Tigers some experience. Connection to Furman there is through one of their assistant coaches, Kyle Jamison. Not necessarily playing for him, but a Furman coach in there. Ground to the third, glide over the first, not in time. Pereira able to beat out the play. Infield single for Cami Pereira.
Now batting, playing center field, number seven, Mackenzie Clark.
Starts things off in a good way for the Clemson Tigers here in the top of the third. Mackenzie Clark will start the second time down the lineup here for Alexa Romero. She flew out to left field her first time up. It was a deep one too. Backed up Harris Woods all the way to the track, a few steps shy of the wall. She had just missed the pitch that she hit. It was on a 3-2 count. Just got a little bit under it. Now a fly ball into right field. Going back is the right fielder, Hasso, and she won't get to that one. A two-run shot. for Mackenzie Clark, making the adjustment, this time going oppo. And Clemson takes the lead, 2-1.
Now batting, playing shortstop number 8, Ainsley Hillstra.
That one wasn't even close to staying in the field of play, and now Ainsley Gilstrap steps in for her second at bat. Lined out to left field in the first inning and takes strike one here. Gilstrap thought about swinging at that one, decided against it, works to her benefit. As the count goes even at 1-1. The 1-1. Bunt attempt, and Gilstrap able to pull back before the ball crossed the plate. The 2-1 the count. Swing and a foul ball down the third baseline. Bouncing towards the Syracuse dugout. Count goes even at 2-2. Ball 3. Count full. Payoff pitch to Gilstrap. Swung on, grounded towards Casares Mayer. Up with it, throw to first in time for out number 1. In will step Valerie Cagle.
Now batting the pitcher, number 72, Valerie Cagle.
Walked her first time up, was then caught stealing second. And she will take strike one on the outside part of the plate here. Looper into left will drop for a base hit. In between Paris Woods and Nellie Casares Mayer. Cagle able to single on the blooper.
Now batting, playing right field, number 25, Marissa Gambarda.
We'll bring in Marissa Gambarda. First time up. Also walked. She was the beneficiary of the caught stealing. Came up again in the top of the second, walked to lead it off. First pitch in there for strike one. One down here in the top of the third. Clemson has already scored 2 in this inning, courtesy of a Mackenzie Clark 2-run home run. One one from Romero. Foul ball down the right field line. Puts the count at 1-2. To line towards shortstop, Casares Mayer makes the catch.
Here we go,
not have a play at first.
Now batting, playing first base, number 58, Kaya.
Two down here in the top of the third. As Cazares Mary able to scoop that ball up off the dirt before it hit ground. Kaya Keller steps in, grounded into a fielder's choice her first time up, and she takes strike one hacking here. The 0-1 line towards Tehran. She'll make the play and end the inning. Damage done, though, by the Clemson Tigers. A two-run shot from Mackenzie Clark gives them the lead as we head to the bottom of the third. It's 2-1 Clemson over the Cuse here on ACC Network Extra. Paris Woods, Calista Almer, Angel Hasso upcoming for Syracuse. They trail the Clemson Tigers 2-1. Those two runs scored on three hits in the top of the third for the Tigers, and the biggest one, of course, coming from the center fielder, Mackenzie Clark. A two-run shot to give the Tigers the lead. Valerie Cagle, after giving up that home run in the first inning to Nellie Casares-Mayer, got right back on track, though.
Leading off for the Syracuse Orange in the bottom of the third inning, playing left field, number 21, Paris.
And now she will face off against the nine-hole hitter, Paris Woods, who steps in for her first at bat of the series of the afternoon, a 244 hitter this season. First pitch swung on, line towards center field. Going back is Clark, and that one's gone. First pitch swinging, Paris Woods ties the game at two. And the bats have come out for Syracuse so far this afternoon. First, Casares Mayer, now Paris Woods. And right after Syracuse had conceded the lead, they tie the game right back up at two. Paris Woods, third home run on the season. And back to the top of the lineup we go. First, though, a meeting in the circle. Valerie Cagle has given up two home runs in this game to the Syracuse lineup. And Cagle had only given up three home runs on the entire season. The velocity that she has at her disclosure to use is not stunned all of the Syracuse hitters so far today. And now the second time through the lineup, all of the Orange hitters have seen her and will be making adjustments. The same could be said on the other end as well with Alexa Romero against the Clemson hitters. We saw Mackenzie Clark make an adjustment to hit one out of the park. And now Syracuse will head into the second time around the order. First pitch swinging from Almer, strike one. She struck out swinging her first time up. Ooh, pitch way out of the zone, low. Almer couldn't hold up. Almer is transfer from Dartmouth. Was also the former stomping grounds of Syracuse's head coach, Shannon Depking. Swing and a ball fouled softly towards the Clemson dugout.
Come on,
Pitch in the dirt, ball two. Strike three on the outside corner. Almer set down on strikes for the second time, this time looking. The fifth strikeout for Cagle. Stepping in now, Angel Hasso. She was a strikeout victim her first time up as well. Take ball one outside and low. The 1-0 from Cagle. Outside ball two. Liner towards second base, lunging to the ground and making the catch, Cammy Pereira. Some sharp feet in the infield from both sides today. Nellie Casares-Mayer has a pair of those sharp feet, and she rides them right into the batter's box. Last time up, hit the home run to right center field to give Syracuse a 1-0 lead. Pitch rising on out of the zone from Cagle for ball one. Second pitch, and Casares-Mayer just missed that one, fouling it off over the screen. One from Cagle. Outside, ball two. Two-one from Cagle. Swung on, grounded to the first base, and making the diving play and tagging the bag with her glove. To end the inning is Kaya Keller. One run scores on the Paris Woods home run, and Syracuse has tied the game at two. We'll head to the top of the fourth. Clemson coming up with Johnson, Matamor, and Bigham after the break. Top of the fourth, upcoming as the throw goes down to second. Score tied at two, and they've all come from the long ball. First, Nellie Casares-Mayer. Then Mackenzie Clark on the Clemson side, and most recently Paris Woods for Syracuse. That's how we're tied up at two. Morgan Johnson will lead things off here in the top of the four for the Tigers.
Leading off for the Clemson Tigers in the top of the fourth inning, the designated player.
Her first time up, she struck out on three pitches swinging. First pitch from Romero. Swung on and missed. The 0-1. Bit outside, bit high, ball one. That was the 58th pitch thrown by Alexa Romero. 59 is a bit low, ball two. The 2-1. Swung on and missed. Strike two. Johnson is, as of yet, been unable to make contact, bat on ball. Five strikes against her have come by the swing and miss. The 2-2. Upstairs, ball three. Fourth hitter that's gone to a full count on Alexa Romero. Time called by Johnson. She'll step out. Three, two. Outside, ball four. Fourth walk dished out by Romero.
Now playing left field number 27, Grace Matamore.
And now Grace Matamore will step in. She walked her first time up. Now the long strides of Morgan Johnson on first. First pitch, low, ball one. In strike one. A little bit of movement on that one. Matamore checked her swing, didn't go really anywhere near. The 1-1. Fun attempt here. Matamore lays it down through the center. Throw to first. Goes away up the line. And Jasso will hold as Johnson goes from first to third on the bunt. Time called by Syracuse. Runners on the corners for Clemson. With no one out, and Casey Bigham coming to the plate. Again, no one out. Runners on first and third. Pinch runner on at first. Clemson, Jaden Cheek.
Now batting, playing third base, number two.
Casey will run for Matamore. Casey Bigham at the plate with a chance to do some damage here for Clemson. First pitch from Romero, swing and a miss. Pitch upstairs, ball one. Ball two, up and away. One to Bigham, runners on the corners. Clemson a chance to try and take the lead right back. Swing and a miss, strike two. Romero trying to take one step to getting out of a jam. Almost going around, and the appeal that it was not in the strike zone from the first base umpire. Bigham takes ball three, full count. Three, two, swung on, no, fouled off, not missed. Torres couldn't handle the tip. And Romero will do the 3-2 over again. The 3-2 again. This time, swing and a miss. Bigham set down for the second time on strikes, and there's one down here in the top of the fourth. In will step the nine hitter, Cammy Pereira.
Now batting, playing second base, number 12, Cammy Pereira.
She singled her first time up and was driven in on the Mackenzie Clark home run. First pitch swinging, it'll be fouled, out of play. Clemson a big chance here to tack on some runs and put pressure on the Syracuse offense to solve Valerie Cagle's velocity, and now a meeting at the circle. The entire infield will come in, along with Torres. Take a quick look at the schedule for this series between Syracuse and Clemson. It's the last regular season series for both teams before the ACC tournament. Obviously, you have the game going on as we speak. I'm Brendan Hodges bringing it here for you. Two games scheduled for tomorrow. Those will be on ACC Network Extra as well. Ben Shulman and Faith Kane will have the call for those two. Scheduled for 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. I'll be back here on Sunday, though, at noon for the fourth and final game of this series. Again, right here on ACC Network Extra. 0-1 here to Pereira. Squared to bunt. Called strike two on the whiff. And now Pereira down 0-2 to Romero. Infield is creeping in. The 0-2 inside, a little high, ball one. One, two from Romero. Oh, she thought she had Pereira there. Just missed though, 2-2. Romero gets the sign from the dugout. The 2-2, swung on, fouled back into the screen. Two. Again, fouled back into the screen. Oh, 2-2, swung on, grounded towards first, gets by Ulmer. A run will score. And being held at second is Matamor. Cheek. 3-2 on the RBI single from Cammy Pereira. And now with one down and two runners on, Mackenzie Clark will step back into the batter's box. Her third at bat today. Flew out to left her first time up, made an adjustment, and then hit one out to right. First pitch, Hacken fouls one off into the screen. Cheek, the runner at second. Pereira, the runner at first. Clark in the batter's box. That pitch gets away from Torres, but only far enough to where she can get it. No advance from the runners. Count to 1-1. One to Clark, low, ball two. The 2-1, low outside, ball three. From Romero. Popped up into right. Hasso over in foul territory makes the catch. The runners will tag, look to advance, and they will do so safely. Matamor moves to third. Pereira to second on the sack fly. Now two down for Ainsley Gilstrap. 0-2 so far. Lined out to left and grounded to shortstop. Alexa Romero looking to limit the damage that Clemson can do here in the fourth. First pitch, high and inside, ball one. Side, ball two, Gilstrap able to lay off it. Strike one on the outside corner. Off the outside corner that time, ball three. Cagle on deck. If Gilstrap can either walk or drive in a run. She will walk and the bases will be loaded. And Valerie Cagle will come to the plate. Gianna Torres sending signs to her defense. Again, Cagle, 12 home runs on the season, hitting 411 coming into today. She'll take strike one. Singled her last time up. One for one today is Cagle. The 0-1 just a bit outside. One swung on and missed. Romero blew in it by Cagle. One strike away from getting out of a bases loaded jam. Swing and a miss. Romero gets out of another big time jam and limits the damage to just one. Clemson tacks on one. It's 3-2 as we head to the bottom of the fourth. Syracuse coming up with Tehran, Mayfield, Torres after the break. After 3.5 innings. Two hits bringing in the one run for Clemson in the top of the fourth. Syracuse looking to answer in the bottom half. Gabby Tehran will lead things off for the Orange. After Alexa Romero able to escape from a bases loaded jam, she allowed one run to score, did not allow any more. And now Syracuse, whose bats have come alive at least a little bit today. They've done it with a deep ball. Two home runs for the Cuse so far today. Nelly Casares Mayer, Paris Woods, and the first time through the order. Leilani Mayfield, the only other hit for the Orange, a second inning single. She'll be coming up second here in the bottom of the fourth.
Leading off for the Syracuse Orange in the bottom of the fourth inning, playing second base, number 4, Gabby Tehran.
Tehran. We'll go up against Cagle second time today. She grounded out to shortstop her first time up. There's a discussion going on between the first base umpire and Syracuse's first base coach that has halted play for the moment. And now the bottom of the fourth will commence. Gabby Tehran watches ball one skip through the dirt. Second pitch grounded over the short. Gill strapped to first in time for out number one.
Now batting, the designated player, number 23.
Designated player, Leilani Mayfield. Singled right up the middle on the first pitch of her first at bat. Made it all the way to third, did not score. Ball one, skipping through the dirt again from Cagle. One out to Mayfield. Check swing, she went around. Strike one, it's 1-1. That's the count to Mayfield. Pitch inside, ball two. Yeah, 2-1 pitch from Cagle. Swung on and fouled back into the screen. Syracuse hitters have not shied away from taking hacks at fastballs from Cagle. Have not caught up to all of them, but they have to a few, and that's how they've got their two runs. Pitch low out of the zone. Count will go full. Count does go full. Three-two, swung on, grounded towards shortstop. Gilstrap has it over to first in time for out number two.
Now batting, the catcher number 40,
Gianna Torres. Take her second stab at Valerie Cagle. Two down here in the bottom of the fourth. Clemson leads 3-2. Torres, first pitch chopped up towards third, digging for first, gets there safely ahead of the throw from Casey Bigham. So a runner on with two down. Tony Martin will step to the plate. Martin struck out looking on a full count. Her first time up. She watches ball one go by here. Swing and a miss on the changeup. Inside ball two. Two, one, check swing, appeal down to first. Yes, she went around. Two down, runner on first, Torres. 2-2 pitch coming from Cagle to Tony Martin. In there for strike three on the inside corner. That ends the inning. No runs on one hit. No errors committed by Clemson. We head to the top of the fifth. The Tigers lead Syracuse 3-2.
One hit, no Clemson errors, one runner left.
Top of the fifth. Set to get underway. Clemson will come forward with Gombardo, Keller, and Johnson. One of them reaches. Grace Matamor will step up to the plate.
Tigers in the top of the fifth inning, playing right field number 25, Marissa Gombardo.
For now, though, Marissa Gombardo will step in for her third at bat. She walked her first time up and lined out to shortstop. Clemson leads 3-2 as they search for an outright regular season championship in the ACC, the first of this program's young existence, and in their first try at it, really. Liner into right. Paso is there to make the play.
Now batting, playing first base, number 58, Kaya Keller.
Kaya Keller now steps in. Keller 0-for-2. Grounded into a fielder's choice and lined out to second. This pitch high and inside for ball one. Square into bunt, popped it up behind the plate, but it hits off the net. Count goes even at one ball, one strike. The 1-1 from Romero. Just off the plate outside, 2-1. Swing and a drive foul. That would have been out of here if she kept it fair. Well, that is well hit down into foul territory and well away from this softball complex. Count goes even, 2 balls, 2 strikes. Romero. This pitch fouled off towards the Clemson dugout. Romero has had to work hard. There's no question about that. Faced a couple of sticky situations, has gotten out of most of them. Has kept this Clemson offense at bay, and that continues. Kaya Keller goes down swinging.
Now batting the designated player, number 42. Morgan
fifth strikeout for Alexa Romero. And now in steps Morgan Johnson. She walked on a full count her last time up, came all the way around to score the go-ahead run for the Tigers, and she will take ball one here. Swing and a miss, strike one. Johnson is really not made contact with much coming from Romero today. Every pitch she has swung at, she's missed, and every pitch she hasn't swung at has been out of the zone. That trend continues. Two pitch outside, trying to get Johnson to chase. Romero could not. Count goes even at 2 balls, 2 strikes. The 2-2. Got Johnson on the elbow, and she will take the trot down to first.
Now batting, playing left field, number 27, Grace Matamor.
And we'll bring in Grace Matamor with 2 down. And Johnson on first after the hit by pitch. Matamor reached on an error her last time up. She's trying to sacrifice and throw went away from the first baseman, Almer, up the line and allowed her to reach. Take strike one on the inside part of the plate. Pitch upstairs, taking ball one. 1-1. Just a bit inside. Count to 3-1. Watching strike two go by Matamor. Count goes full. It's happened more than I'm sure Alexa Romero would like. The sixth time it's happened. Payoff pitch here, fouled into the screen. Johnson will be running. She did on that last pitch, she will be on this one. Infield backs up to the edge of the dirt. Swing and a miss. Romero ends the top of the fifth with a strikeout and no runs come across despite the hit by pitch of Morgan Johnson. It's 3-2. Clemson leads as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Syracuse coming up with Clyde, Woods, and Ulmer after the break. Well, the first time that Clemson and Syracuse meet in ACC softball history has been a good one so far. It's 3-2, Clemson leading Syracuse as we head to the bottom of the fifth. These two teams were scheduled to play in mid-March last year, late March actually, and John Rittman's squad was unable to play them as their inaugural season was cut short. But it has been a treat to watch so far this afternoon. Brendan Hodges here with you as we hit the bottom of the fifth. Rebecca Clyde leads it off for Syracuse. She grounded out to second on one pitch. Her last time up. Clyde hitting 163 on the year. Grounder foul down the third baseline. Syracuse hitters have choked up a little on the bats. And they were going to do so anyway because of the velocity that Valerie Cagle has at her disposal. But they are choking up a little bit more now. Ball one skips through the dirt to Clyde. Clyde does have a couple of doubles and a triple on the year. Struck out 34 times, though. And she fouls a pitch into her foot. Liner foul into the net in front of the Syracuse dugout. Able to lay off a low pitch. Count evens up at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Cagle has been trying to get Syracuse hitters to chase pretty much all day. Hasn't had much success with it. This time she does, though, as Clyde goes for a low pitch, strikes out swinging, and one is down here in the top of the fifth, which brings in Paris Woods, her first time up.
Playing the field, number 21, Paris.
Hit a shot to center field, maybe a little bit into left center, based upon my angle. took the first pitch that way as well. Squaring the bunt and fouls it into the back of the screen. One grounded softly towards Gilstrap at short, muffs it, and everyone's going to be safe. Woods on board with a single. We'll see if they give an error to Gilstrap on that play. They will count that as an error to Gilstrap, so... No matter what, Woods is on at first, and Ulmer, trying to bunt her over, fouls one off and away. Ulmer is struck out twice, once looking, once swinging. Tries to bunt again and off the top of her bat and out of fair territory. Count 0-2. The 0-2 from Cagle. Outside. Ball one. Wind has picked up a bit, moving from left to right. And the 1-2 from Keg, foul back to the screen. Eagle shakes off one pitch, shakes off two, steps back. And JoJo Hyatt will trot out to the circle to have a chat. Quick conference. Hyatt back to the plate. Slightest mist starting to come down at Skytop as Ulmer fouls off another pitch. There was rain in the forecast today. The game was pushed up from a 4 o'clock to a 3 o'clock start. In conversation with the staff around here, one who was coming from Rochester. It's pouring rain there. Strike three swinging, Ulmer. Goes down on strikes for the third time today. It's two down via the strikeout here in the bottom of the fifth.
Now batting
Valerie Cagle.
Right field number 28, Angel Hassel.
Eighth strikeout here in game one of this four-game series for Cagle. Runner goes, Woods, in safely at second. Angel Hasso back into the batter's box, 0-2. 1-0, swung on, a looper towards Gilstrap at short. Comes back on it, makes the play. So a runner gets aboard and steals base, but Syracuse cannot convert on the opportunity. It remains 3-2, Clemson on top of Syracuse. We head to the top of the sixth with the Tigers bringing up the bottom of the lineup. Bigum, Pereira, and back to the top with Clark right after the break.
No hits, there was one.
Top of the sixth upcoming. Clemson leads Syracuse 3-2 here on the ACC Network Extra. Brendan Hodges coming to you live from Skytop Stadium on South Campus here at Syracuse University. Clemson head coach John Rittman is out of the dugout to make a change here. Sarah Howell has stepped out of the dugout and is making her way towards the batter's box, so perhaps change for the Tigers here.
Leading off for the Clemson Tigers in the top of the sixth inning, batting for Bigham, number 9, Sarah Howell.
So yes, Sarah Howell will step in for Clemson, has come to the plate 8 times this year, is 1-for-8 on the season. Fouled the first pitch back into the screen. Also 4-for-5 on the base pass in terms of swiping bags. Another foul. That time ringing off one of the posts holding the screen in place. Howell has played in 19 games this year, hasn't started as of yet. But Coach Rittman obviously thinking that she's the best player to put in this situation here. She's down 0-2 in the count. And take strike 3, looking. Seventh strikeout for Romero. And now the 9-hole hitter, Cammy Pereira, steps to the plate. 2 singles on the day for her. 2-for-2 against Alexia Romero. First pitch to her. Upstairs, ball 1. Liner up the middle, coming on is Martins. Tries to scoop it up off the turf, unable to. It'll go down as a single for Cammy Pereira, 3-for-3 on the day. Martin didn't get the best read on that either. Took a step back, then came forward, was just a step too slow to get to it. And it brings in Mackenzie Clarks.
Now batting, playing center field, number 7.
Mackenzie Clark. 1-for-2 on the day. Had a 2-run home run back in her second at bat. Sacrifice fly in her last at bat. That led to the go-ahead run scoring for Clemson. Now Clark takes ball 1 outside and low. Ball 2 outside. Kenzie Clark steps out of the batter's box, gets a sign from the 2-0. Swung on, lifted towards Casares Mayer. What a catch over there at shortstop. Diving into the outfield grass, snares it with her gloved hand for the first out, second out of the inning.
Ainsley Dilstra.
And now 2 down. With Gilstrap at the plate. Gilstrap 0-for-2 with a walk, grounder, Casares Mayer over the first to end the inning. Some more stellar defensive play from the orange out infield. Nelly Casares Mayer with a diving catch to help end the top of the sixth. Syracuse looking to come into the bottom of the sixth to tie the game. It's 3-2 Clemson on top of the Cuse here on the ACC Network Extra. Bottom of the sixth upcoming. Clemson leading Syracuse 3-2 here at Skytop Stadium on the south campus of Syracuse University. The mist, which you can't really call a rain yet, continues to fall onto the bleachers in front of me. As we get into the home stretch of this first of four games between Clemson and Syracuse, that end the regular season for both teams. Both are in position to make the ACC tournament so far. Syracuse right now, eighth in the ACC.
Syracuse Orange in the bottom of the sixth inning, playing shortstop number 11.
Barring
Nelly Casares Mayer.
A number of variables, they are in relatively good shape to make it there. Clemson, number one in the league, is going to be there. It's just a matter of if they're going to be number one or not number one. Florida State right behind them. Duke could conceivably, actually Duke cannot, I don't believe Duke could conceivably take the number one or two seed. It's a race from Clemson, Florida State, and the Seminoles are, I'm sure, watching this game with interest. Nelly Casares Mayer up in the count 2-0. Her one hit today was a home run back in the first. She swings and misses at strike one. The Mayer has been playing well on the defensive end as well. That last half inning, a diving grab onto the outfield grass to get the second out of the inning. Swing and a miss. So the pitch low and inside. Since that first at bat, though, Nelly Casares Mayer has grounded two first and then grounded the shortstop. This time, she'll lay off that pitch low and inside. Count goes full. Three, two. High and inside, Casares Mayer. On to lead off the sixth.
Now batting, playing second base number four, Gabby Terron.
Pinch runner will come in for Nelly Casares Mayer. That is number 20, Ryan Gallegos.
Your attention, running for Casares Mayer.
Gallegos,
number 20,
been used as a pinch Ryan runner most Gallegos of the year. One for one when it comes to swiping bags. That's what she's out there for. Has only been able to take one shot at it, succeeded. Gabby Terron look to move her over. Runner goes. Gallegos to second is in there. Not the best jump from Gallegos, but Gilstrap unable to apply the tag. Now a runner in scoring position. Gabby Terron. Chopper towards the pitcher. Gallegos going to third. No one's covering, so the play is at first. Terron out 5-3, but Gallegos moves to third. And up will come Leilani Mayfield. Mayfield, 1-for-2 today. Singled in her first at bat. Grounded out to shortstop in her second, but chance to have one of the biggest at bats that Syracuse has had today. Again, the tying run at third. Swing and a miss. Mayfield was thinking fastball. Cagle went changeup. 0-1, fouled away. The 0-2. Soft grounder towards shortstop. Gilstrap up with it, over to first for the second out of the inning.
Now batting the catcher number 40, Gianna Torres.
Which brings in Gianna Torres. 1-for-2 today, or last time up, she chopped pitch high into the air. Was able to beat out the play at first. Here she takes strike one down the middle. Tying run is at third in the form of Ryan Gallegos. Torres would love to help her team out to drive her in to tie the game. Pitch upstairs, ball one. And now time is called by Clemson. They'll be meeting in the circle, and while they're doing that, we'll again take a look at the ACC standings. Of course, Clemson, Florida State, top two seeds as of right now. They would get technically a first round bye along with a 4-5. Seeds 7-10 would play in the first set of games. Syracuse is in that group. Along with Georgia Tech, Pitt, Louisville. Count is it even at one ball and one strike on Gianna Torres. Two down, swing and a miss. Swing and a miss. Cagle able to escape unscathed with a strikeout. Gallego stranded at third. And Syracuse will have to wait till the bottom of the seventh for another chance to tie. They got to go back on the defensive, though. Clemson coming up with Gilstrap, Cagle, and Gambarda in the top of the seventh. We'll be right back. Top of the seventh, Clemson leads Syracuse 3-2 in game one of this four-game series to end the regular season. Again, keep tabs on this series throughout the weekend. If this game is any indication, it's going to be a good one. Ben Shulman, Faith Kane will be on the call tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock, respectively, for games 2 and 3. I'll be back here along with Sam Oppenheim for game 4 at noon on Sunday. Top of the seventh, set to get underway. Valerie Cagle into the batter's box. Lines one right past the leg of Alexa Romero on the first pitch. And lead runner aboard, Cagle. Second hit of the day. She's now 2 for 3 with a pair of singles. And now it looks as though change will be made here by Clemson. It's a pinch runner for Cagle. And on in her stead will be Carly Shannon. She's been used mainly as a pinch runner this year. A perfect 17 for 17 on the base pass. She knows how to steal bases. Marissa Gambarda will take a big hack at the first pitch and miss. It was low, maybe even a little bit out of the zone for strike one. The 0-1. Grounded through the left side of the infield. Shannon moves up to second. That's as far as she'll go. Clemson looking to threaten here and threaten to extend the lead here in the top of the seventh. Another pinch runner will come into the game for Gambarda. Ariel Oda. Redshirt freshman will step on to first base. 4 for 4 on the season, stealing bases.
Number 24, Ariel Oda. Now batting, playing first base.
Kaya Keller.
Kaya Keller.
Who is 0 for 3. Reached on a fielder's choice back in her first at bat. Struck out in her most recent at bat. But now a runner in scoring position and no one out. First pitch high and out of the zone, ball one. Pitch fouled off the screen. Count even at one ball and one strike. The 1-1. Grounded towards third, but foul. Count to 1-2. Romero will get a new ball from the umpire. Again, there's a slight mist coming down here in Syracuse. So Romero wanting a ball that's dry so she can get a little more grip on it. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. Gets Keller swinging. One down.
Now batting the designated player, number 42, Morgan Johnson.
Eighth strikeout for Romero. And Morgan Johnson will step in. And Romero's had her way with her so far today. Check swing from Johnson. She did not go around, ball one. Minus a walk and a hit by pitch that Johnson has been the beneficiary of. She hasn't really sniffed anything that Romero has thrown to her. No contact made as of yet. 1-0. This time she does, though. A liner towards the gap. Cut off by Martin. A run will score. It's 4-2 Clemson with an RBI single by Morgan Johnson. Clemson in a big insurance run as we head down the home stretch of game one.
Now batting playing left field number 27, Grace Matamor.
Grace Matamor, who last time out struck out on a full count. She is 0 for 2. She also reached on an error earlier today. Watches ball one go by. The 1-0. Crossed up Matamor a bit. She didn't want to swing too early. Watch strike one go by that time. One. Swing and a miss. Matamor down to the count, 1-2. Runner on second, Oda. Runner on first, Johnson. And Matamor at the plate. Stays alive in the bat. Fouling a pitch off. Liner into right, Hasso there to make the play. Runners retreat. Two down in the top of the seventh.
Now batting, playing third base, number 2, Casey Bigham.
Casey Bigham steps in. She was pinch hit for the last time through the order. 0 for 2 today, 2 strikeouts. And she takes strike one here. Two down in the top of the seventh. Alexa Romero trying to keep the deficit as small as possible. Bunt attempt fouled into the screen. Count to 0-2. Romero trying to keep the Clemson lead at 2. And give her teammates a shot to bring the orange back in the bottom half of the seventh. The 0-2. Outside, ball one. Good work behind the plate by Torres to keep that pitch in front of her. Two, foul back over the top of the press box. The 1-2 again. Oh, over the head of Torres, the runners will advance. Count to 2-2. Johnson ends up on second. Oda ends up on third. Force play off except for at first. Two, two. Upstairs, inside, ball three. And Gianna Torres will walk the ball back out to Romero. Have a short chat.
Let's go,
Payoff pitch. Grounded right back to Romero. She flips it over to Ulmer, and that ends the inning. We head to the bottom of the seventh. Syracuse, last chance to tie the score. It's 4-2. Clemson heading into the bottom of the seventh. Syracuse will come up with the bottom of their order. Tony Martin, Becca Clyde, Paris Woods after the break. Bottom of the seventh, upcoming. Cagle has re-entered the game at pitcher, and a change in right field for Clemson. Ariel Oda, who came in to run for Marissa Gambarda, remains in the game in right field. And now a pinch hitter for Syracuse.
Your attention, leading off for Syracuse in the bottom of the seventh inning, batting for Martin.
Tony Martin, not up in the batter's box here. Maxine Barnes will step in for Syracuse. The sophomore has 26 trips to the plate so far this year. First pitch foul back. Hitting 115 on the season, but Shannon Depking looking for something on the offensive end. 0-1 to Barnes, fouled back again. The 0-2 to Barnes, swing and a miss. Cagle sets one down. One away in the bottom of the seventh.
Now batting playing third base number three.
Rebecca Clyde. Into the batter's box, 0-2. Strikeout, ground out to second. First pitch upstairs, ball one. Grounder, fouled off her, the back of her leg. Count evens up at one ball, one strike. One. Skipping through the dirt, ball two. That one off the foot of Clyde. She'll be awarded first base on the hit by pitch. Syracuse with a runner on, one down, and Paris Woods coming to the plate.
Now batting, playing left field number 21, Paris Woods.
Pinch runner on for Clyde. Olivia Pess off the bench for the Orange. Has not attempted to steal a base this year. She is called upon
first base for Clyde, number 18, Olivia Pess.
In a huge moment for the Orange. Paris Woods also called upon. 1-for-2 today. She reached on an error in her last at bat. Hit a home run earlier. He takes ball one, outside, maybe a little bit high as well. Ulmer is on deck. One oh, swung on, lined over the head of Gilstrap, in for a base hit. Pass will stay at second. And the Orange have a runner in scoring position with one down here in the bottom of the seventh. Palmer, 0-3 today. Three strikeouts. He's trying to lay down a bunt in her last at bat. Was unable to. Velocity of Cagle keeping her from doing such. She won't try and bunt here, instead taking ball one. In the zone on the outside corner. Count to 1-1. Swing and a miss, strike two. Off grounder to third, tagging third over to first in time. Casey Bigham makes the defensive play in game one, taken by the Clemson Tigers 4-2. And what a game it was. Home runs on both sides and stellar defensive play. And how about you cap it off with an inning-ending double play? That's all from Skytop Stadium. Again, the final score, the Clemson Tigers 4, Syracuse Orange 2. I'm Brendan Hodges. Thanks for joining us on ACC Network Extra, and tune in tomorrow for games 2 and 3. Of this series. Clemson taking on Syracuse at 1 p.m., 3 p.m. Ben Shulman, Faith Kane will have the call for you. For now, though, for the crew here and myself, have a wonderful rest of your Friday. Again, final score, Clemson 4, Syracuse 2.